Incorporated, NACO, is pleased to announce the job opportunity to you. It says we have immediate openings for second shift warehouse associate. The starting wage is $11.55 an hour. Send resumes of qualified applicants. It gives a website, pdcjobs@nmhg.com. But I will post this on the board. These resumes have to be in by August the 10th. Amen? Amen. This announcement, shut-in time, the Lord is speaking to you. Come and spend time with him without any interruptions. Where? Battle Focus Ministries, 501 Cunningham. They canceled it. Okay. This says revised dates. Okay. I don't know. But it says Friday, August the 10th at 7 through Sunday, August the 12th, ending at 6 p.m. We believe you will be blessed. Prayer and fasting is what will get us through these trying times. Amen. From the desk of Alderman Davis, this concerns voter registration. The deadline, the last day to register is October the 19th. And you can call 554-1930. And I don't know if you also know that if you come down to do anything with your driver's license, that you can register to vote. Y'all come soon. That's all I can say. Come soon. This announcement is for our challenge softball game, calling all young adults. It's for a team that will be assembled for the church picnic on August 31st. We older adults challenge you to a softball game. If you would like to sign up, please contact Brian Rose, coach for the young adults, or Elder Danny Odoms, coach for the older adults. And ladies are welcome to sign up also. Amen. And then I will post this one here. This is Unity in the Community. The Danville Caucus is an awesome group that does awesome things in this community. A lot of people do not know about the Danville Caucus, but they really make a concentrated effort on making our community better. And this event, it's March for Academic Excellence. It's August the 18th, 1 p.m. There will be a parade from the Family Dollar General or from the Dollar General parking lot to Carver Park. After you get there, there's going to be gifts, music, free food, giveaways. Contact Letitia Wilson at 390-7075 or Gladys Davis at 443-2757. And then we know that we have this event coming up, everybody. Amen. Hallelujah. It's been announced and it's already posted on the board, but we know that we need to be reminded sometimes in our busy lives. So don't forget the Youth Rally, Catch Fire, New Life Church of Faith Youth Department presents. Amen. Amen. On August the 17th and the 18th, that's a Friday and a Saturday evening. Doors open at 5:30. The concert starts at 6, and the guest speaker will be Pastor Julio Anduo. Amen? Amen. So be sure that you come and support our youth. Amen. I have a thank you here, Pastor Miller, First Lady Beverly Miller, and my church family. Your prayers, kind words, and uplifting hugs were greatly appreciated in the time of bereavement. Thanks so much. Yours in Christ, Tassie McCullough and family. Amen. And from the family of Evelyn March, my mother-in-law, amen. Pastor and Sister Miller and New Life family, thank you for every card, prayer, hug, phone call, and visit during the loss of our grandmother. She was an incredible woman, and to feel and see your love and support truly confirmed that and brought us such peace. We love you, New Life family. Sincerely, Danny and Kelly Odoms and Minister Charlene Randall. Amen. Amen. And we have Our birthdays for starting the month of August, August 1st, Sister Beatrice Buford, amen. August 2nd, Minister Dave Reed, amen. August 3rd, Sister Shirley Wilson. August 4th, Sister Miss Shirley Odoms. August the 5th, Sister Shelley Howard. August 5th, Sister Yolanda Flanagan. And August the 7th, Sister Janila Phipps. And then this Saturday, or Friday, August the 10th, Elder Earl Miller. Amen. Amen. And our... You didn't get last week's? Oh. I don't have the last week's bulletin. I got one in my Bible down there. Yeah, it's all tore up, but... All right. Okay. All right, okay. And then we have the August anniversaries, August 3rd, Brother George III and Minister Marilyn Jimson. 38 years, y'all. Woo! 38 years. That's some work. August the 8th, Elder George and Sister Brenda Rose, 20th anniversary. Amen. August 8th, Brother Carl and Sister Danae Hayes, 4th anniversary. August the 9th, Brother Red and Minister Anjanette Brown, 11th anniversary. Amen. And then I'll read the rest next week, and I will see if I can find the birthdays for last week. Afraid it's torn in half. There's one in the garbage can in your office. I just threw it away this morning. That's okay. All right, he said that's okay. Praise God. Praise God. Okay. Anybody that had a birthday on last week, we wish you a happy birthday. What day? Oh, you got July? You want to run it up here to me? All right. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. July, what was 27? What was last week? The 30th? Okay, I'm just going to go from the 24th. July the 24th, Sister Kendra Carter. July the 26th, Sister Tia Awodia. July the 26th, Sister Chana Worthington. July the 28th, Brother DeAndre Daniel. July the 28th, Brother Philip Hall. July the 28th, Sister Michaela Hall. July the 29th, Sister Sylvia Gibson. July the 31st, Sister Dorothy Buford. July 31st, Mother Lillian Wade. July the 31st, Brother Isaac Carter. And July the 31st, Julian Wilson Kalunga, who had his first birthday. Amen. Amen. This says, listen up, all youth. Oh, how we have missed you. Sunday school will begin meeting on Sunday, August 19th, 2012. Bible study will begin meeting the following Wednesday, August 22nd, 2012. The youth department staff is looking forward to working with you to reintroduce, reacquaint, and strengthen your relationship with Jesus. Amen. Listen up, all adults. That's what happens when you give somebody a mic. We miss you at Sunday school. I'm just asking if you would just come out at Sunday school. I have a faithful member. Sister Florence, just stand up. It says give honor where honor is due. Sister Florence is there no matter what. So y'all come and join us at Sunday school. Lately, it's just been she and I. We have a wonderful time, but we need more. Amen. Praise God. I would like to welcome the visitors this morning. If we have any visitors for the first time at New Life Church of Faith, would you please stand? Praise God. Keep standing, hon. Remain standing. Okay. And we have a young lady in the back here. We would just like to welcome you this morning. I want to say that you're not here by accident, because God is not a random God. Okay, you're here for a reason. And we welcome you to come back again. And even if you don't happen to come back again, we know that you were here today for a purpose. Amen. So, anybody? We're going to shake your hands this morning. Amen. Stay standing. Remain. Come up here. Come up. Amen. Amen.
Tomorrow we are at 6. We are having our community choir rehearsal for the Catch Fire. And on Tuesday, anybody who wants their children to participate to dance in the youth rally, Tuesday we're having practice here at 6. So bring your kids.
Amen. Praise God. We're going to go and shake the hands of the visitors. Remain standing, hon.
I ain't never been Amen. We're just going to keep flowing in the blood. How about that? The blood of Jesus. Amen. With all the methods that we've seen, the old ones and the new, there's still no cure that's strong enough to take the pain from you. Wounds you suffered in your life remain open deep inside. There is a cure, for there's power in Jesus' blood. How to change the history, the story of a life, to turn around from traveling the wrong way to the right. Though you've wasted so much time having lies yet living life, there is an answer, for there's power in Jesus' blood. Whoa. There's power in his blood that can take away your sin. There's power in his blood to restore you from within. Though your life is stained like scarlet, he will wash you, wash you white as snow, soul saving power, healing power. There's freeing power, there's power in his blood. Oh, yes, there's power in his blood that can take away your sin. And there's power in his blood to restore you from within. Though your life is stained like scarlet, he will wash you white as snow. Soul-saving power, healing power. There's freedom. There's power in his blood to restore you from within. Though your life is stained like scarlet, he will wash you white as snow. Soul-saving power, healing power. Hallelujah. It's freeing power. Hallelujah. There's power in his blood. Hallelujah. Give God some praise for the power of the blood. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised. Come on and give God some praise. He's done too much. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, keep praising him this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord. His saving power, his healing power, his deliverance power. Hallelujah. Come on, let's thank God. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord, for your blood today. We thank you for everybody in the building, God. We thank you, Lord, for your holy word, and I pray you speak to me, speak through me. And God, I give you all the credit, the glory, and the honor in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen and amen. Come on, somebody shout glory. Shout hallelujah. Come on and shout thank you, Jesus. Come on, throw your head back and shout, ooh, hallelujah. Come on, give God some more praise in this place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is there anybody come to praise him? Come on and give him some glory. Come on, somebody, bring your own tambourine. Bring your own trumpet. Bring your own drums. Bring your own keyboard. Come on and open up your mouth. Come on, let's harmonize in this place. Everybody praising the Lord. Come on and get something in your mouth that you would give God some praise for. Don't you let the devil today make you sit on God's praise. God's been too good. You may not have all the money, but if you got a little money, come on and give him praise. You may not feel the best, but thank him for the health that you got. Everything may not be perfect in your relationships, but come on and thank God that you got somebody in your life. Come on and thank God if you still got a mama, if you still got a daddy, if you still got a car, you still got a house, a job to go to in the morning. Come on and thank God. Somebody might want to thank him for saving your soul. Somebody might just want to thank him that you're on your way to heaven and you're so glad. Somebody might want to praise him for where he brought you from. Come on today. Don't sit on the praises. Don't get in this place and sit on God's praise. He needs you today. A corporate praise. You got a mouth. He said that everything that have breath, praise the Lord. I feel like praising him. He's been so good to me and my family. He's been so good to this local church. He's been so good to these United States. We ought to tell God thank you. We ought to give God some praise. Hallelujah. He ain't going to leave us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know the band ain't playing live music today, but we ought to bring our own instrument in case the band don't show up. I brought my own praise. I brought my own Hammond. I brought my own bass fiddle. It's down on the inside. And when I think of the goodness of what Jesus has done for me, not on last year, but just on yesterday, just on this last week, could have been one of those funerals and they would have had mine. But God said not so. Come on and tell God thank you. Yeah. Come on, somebody shout. Yeah. 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 Hallelujah. Come on, shake the devil off. Come on and get God in this place. Come on, somebody. Say, welcome, Holy Ghost, Spirit of the living God. Come on in. We need more of the Holy Spirit. We need more of your presence. We need you to lift the burdens. We need you to heal sin sick souls. We need you this morning. Hallelujah. Help us right now. Get our minds stayed on you, for you will keep us in perfect peace. Hallelujah. Come on, give God the best hallelujah you got. Come on, give him the best hallelujah. Come on, give him the best glory. 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 Yeah, 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 yeah. Woo. Anybody agree with the pastor today? God been good to New Life Church of Faith. Anybody can agree today? If God has done anything, he's done it for you. Come on and tell God thank you. That's all he's looking for. Somebody that got a thank you in your mouth. A thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, high five at least one or two people. Say, God been too good for me to sit down in this place. God been too good for me to look all crazy, to act all uppity. I don't care if I sweat my weave back. That's right. Not my perm, but I'll make a weave sweat. Come on and shout glory. Hallelujah. Yeah, yeah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, this is the only party I'm going to today. Hallelujah. Yeah, I'm not leaving here going to motorcycle club. This is it for me. Hallelujah. I'm not stopping by main package. I got all the spirit I need right now. I'm not going by the spirit shop. I'm going to welcome the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Somebody turn the rest of the lights back on. Maybe that's it. They think it's too dark in here. It's, hallelujah. Turn some lights on then. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Woo. Bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Am I telling the truth? God been good to us. I said, am I telling the truth? Tell your neighbor, look at the air's on today. You could be outdoors. You could be in the church with no air today. You better give God some praise. Has anybody had any air condition through the month of July? That's just enough right there to tell God thank you. I heard Minister Charlene say she got up in the middle of the night when she heard the lightning flashing and the thunder roaring and said, thank you, Lord. You didn't send some rain. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. It's a dry time, but I still got some praise. It's a dry time, but I still feel like praising him. If the rain don't come, is there anybody still want to praise him? If the sun don't shine, will you still give him praise? If your money funny, will you still give him some praise? If you don't have no honey, will you still give him some praise? Come on, somebody. It's a praising God time. Come on, somebody. Say, come on, Holy Ghost. We need a Holy Ghost takeover. Come on, somebody. Say, more of the Holy Ghost. The truth. Whenever you're down, you need more Holy Ghost. Whenever you're sick, you need more Holy Ghost. Whenever you're going through a storm, you need more of the Holy Ghost presence to show up in your life. Everything that you ever get in the physical earth that you will enjoy, it's the work of the Holy Ghost. He's the only one that can move your pain. It ain't the doctor, it's the Holy Ghost that move your pain, because he's the one that got in the medicine. He got in the medicine. Come on here. Hallelujah. If anybody gonna straighten your husband and wife out, it's gonna be the Holy Ghost. Anybody going to straighten our children out? It's going to be the Holy Ghost. Anybody going to straighten us church folks out? It's going to be the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody. Say, we need more of your Holy Spirit. Come on, somebody. Say, we need a Holy Ghost takeover. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Okay, you can be seated. Don't go to sleep, though. Amen. We've been redundant with songs about the blood today, because under the instructions that the Lord's given me today, we need to talk about the blood. That's why we've been redundant, because it says you got to tell somebody seven times before they can get it. Tell people one time, they don't get it. Two times, they don't get it. Three times, take seven times hearing it before it actually get to your inner being. Tell your neighbor, it's the blood. It's the blood. We're going to talk about the power of his blood. The power of his blood. Tell your neighbor, it's the power of Jesus' blood. Amen. Somebody said the blood still works. Some of y'all weren't here at the beginning. I was in the back room, but they're supposed to play. His blood still works. Did they play it? The blood still works. The slow version. But it was anointed. I wanted to jump. That's okay. Y'all did good. Is it jumping? It's powerful. Can we do it again? Can we all get in on it? Can you find it? Pull it up. Whatever it was. Blood still works. Come on. Everybody on your feet. Come on.
His blood still works and I'm
crank it up, DJ.
That it never,
ever lost. Woo. Its power.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Yes, it works.
I've been redeemed.
I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb.
Say it again. Say his blood.
His blood still works, and I'm glad to be.
Yes, I am.
I've been redeemed.
your hands a little bit. Come on, hallelujah.
Listen, his blood still works, and I'm here to testify. God is not dead, he's still alive. The same blood that was shed way back at Calvary is the same blood that's working now for me. Oh, his blood redeems me from the stain of sin, and his blood cleanses me deep down within. So if you ask me how I made it and how I've overcome, I can tell you it's because of the blood.
His blood still works, and I'm glad to report that it
never lost its power, and it never
I'm redeemed,
and it's by the blood of the Lamb.
Glory to God.
Thank you for the blood.
How many of you know about the blood today? Yes, God.
Jesus.
Glory to God. And it's all the blood, all the blood, all the blood, all the blood of Jesus. Yes, it does.
Clap your hands, all ye people. Come on, somebody, shout glory. Shout hallelujah. Oh my God, can I get a witness in this place? How many believe that his blood is still working? Hallelujah. Come on, be seated. Hallelujah. I know about you. I feel a little better now. Hallelujah. I feel a little better now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. My. You know, we take communion at first Sunday at this church, but I don't know if all of us understand. It's not a tradition. It's not just something to kind of, you know, wet your little whistle for a moment. It represents the body and the blood of Jesus. And if it wasn't for the blood, where would we be today? All my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus Christ and his righteousness. We're going to look at this for a few minutes today, and we want to talk about the power of his blood. You got to believe what Jesus did for you and I on Calvary's cross by shedding his blood, broke all chains. All the power of Satan was broken because of the blood of the Lamb. Amen. Some folks don't want you to preach on the blood. They want you to think that it's somebody else's blood, but there's no other blood that washes us white as snow but the blood of Jesus. And I'm not talking about your physical white outside or your brown outside. I'm talking about your inside. The inside of you, the part of you that is the real you, the spirit man that you have, that you are, created in the image of God through Christ. He restored us back to that righteous relationship. Amen. So again, we just honor God today and my lovely companion, everyone here today, visitors today, everybody today. We thank God for you today. Let's go quickly to Matthew 6 and 33. And the Bible says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. And so to have that relationship with God, it comes through being a person that's committed to seeking God first. Amen. If you will seek God first, you don't have to ask for no cars, no money, nothing. He automatically gives you all of that stuff. Amen. And so it's critical that you put God first. I don't want to be a person that only calls God in a storm, because then I'm really not even aware if he's going to answer, because I don't know him. How many know you got to know somebody before the storm? You got to know what you're working with before trouble come. Amen. And so the kingdom of God is available to us, but we must seek it first. Amen. So let's move on to talk about today the power of his blood. Look in your Bible, Revelation, last book in your Bible. Look at this. Revelation 12 and 11. Amen. I don't know about you, but I feel like praising him today. Amen. How many can say he ain't took your joy? He ain't took your praise. You still want to praise him on today. Amen. Amen. You can't rely on musicians, because you don't know what's going to happen. You got to bring your own Hammond. Amen. You got to bring your own praise. Amen. Glory to God. Revelations 12 and 11. Y'all there? And it says, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto the death. Whew. How do we overcome the devil? By the blood of the Lamb. How do you defeat him in any area of your life? You overcome by the blood of the Lamb. Now, the blood of Jesus was already shed 2,000 plus years ago. So all of us that are Christians today, it's our faith in the blood of Jesus that gives us the victory. Amen. Now, he says, by the word of their testimony. Come on, somebody. Stand. No, you don't have to stand, but just tell your neighbor that I believe in the blood of Jesus. Your word is, I believe the blood of Jesus is going to deliver me out of this situation. I just believe that the blood of Jesus is going to heal my body. I just believe the blood of Jesus is going to put food on my table. See, I just believe that everything that was ever in place to stop me from being blessed and prosperous, Jesus took care of it when he hung on that cross, when he shed his blood. Amen. So it said, now this is powerful. You got to get this part right here. And it said, they loved not their lives unto the death. Oh God, help us today. Do you know the devil wants to see if you're going to say uncle? The devil wants to see if you're going to say, okay, that's it. I can't take no more. No. You got to take that position to say, I still believe in the blood of the Lamb. I still believe that no matter what come, that I'm not going to go back. Come on here, somebody. I'm going to stand, and even if I lose my life, I don't care how hard it gets, I'm still to the death. I ain't dead yet. It's still the blood of the Lamb. I like that little story that Pastor Elder Lee Reed would say about the woman with the paper and the scissors. And her husband had a discussion, and they got to fighting because he said it was paper and she said it was scissors. And so he started whooping his wife till she was down on the floor and she couldn't even talk no more. But she lifted up her hand and she went, come on, somebody. You ought to have your mind made up to say, I don't care how bad it gets. I believe in the blood of the Lamb of Jesus. Come on, somebody. We got too many folks quitting God. We got too many folks, as soon as they go through a little bit, they quit God. They just get upset and leave God. Well, tell me on your way to leaving God, where are you going but to kiss the devil? Who you think it is that's taking you from the presence of God but the devil? You ain't going nowhere but straight to the place where the enemy wants you, away from the anointing. He want to take you away from the presence of God. And so look right here. Clearly, you and I must understand that they overcome. Some of us, I'm an overcomer. Because I believe in the blood of the Lamb. I believe in it. The power is in the blood. The deliverance was in Jesus' blood. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, look at this. Exodus. Come on, we got to hurry along. We're going to have our Holy Communion in a little bit. Exodus 12 and 13. I want to show you something today. We're just going to walk through here a little bit. Amen. Exodus 12 and 13. Now, what's going on here is that Jehovah had told Moses to go down and tell Pharaoh, let my people go. And so God had sent the plagues on Egypt. He had sent the locusts and he had sent the flies and he had sent the sun wouldn't shine. He turned the blood into the water into blood. You know, he had sent all types of plagues to try to get Pharaoh to let God's people go. And Pharaoh still insisted on not letting God's people go. And so this is what God instructed Moses to tell the children of Israel, to get a lamb that wasn't blemished and to sacrifice this lamb and to take the blood and to apply it on their doorposts. Because that night down in Egypt, God was going to kill every firstborn. And it didn't matter if it was human or an animal. It was going to be great, great anguish and crying down in Egypt. But he said everybody that would have the blood over their doorposts. Hallelujah. Look at this, 12 and 13. And the blood, somebody say, and the blood shall be to you for a token upon your houses. Where ye are, and when I see the blood, that's a good place for a Hammond. No, no, no. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you when I smite the land of Egypt. Come on, somebody, begin to apply the blood of Jesus over your house. Begin to apply the blood of Jesus over your body. Begin to apply the blood of Jesus over your family. Because God said when he see the blood, he will pass over. I don't know if you understand that the world is not going to get better. The Bible said the world's going to wax worse and worse. But how many know when he see the blood, he'll pass over? Come on here. Though trouble is going to be all over this world, though trials are going to continue to happen, though there's going to continue to be murder and violence in the world, if you and I understand the power of the blood, that it don't matter what's going on in this world because I got the blood covering of Jesus over my life and he protects me from whatever God is permitting to happen in the world. Come on here, somebody. The power is in the blood. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody, begin to have faith today. Amen. Revisit this. Come on. And again, get acquainted with the power of the blood of Jesus. It's in the power of the blood of Jesus that down in Egypt, not one of the Israelites lost anybody, because the blood of Jesus, that little lamb, that little sheep that was slain, it was a prerequisite to the blood of Jesus. All of the Old Testament is leading up to the crucifixion. Everything that was going on back then was to show us what the blood of Jesus was going to do for us. Amen. Hebrews 9 and 22. Thank you, Jesus. 9 and 22. Come on, somebody, say, it's the blood of Jesus that makes us whole. Amen? Now, you got to have faith in it, though. See, a lot of folks don't have faith in it, even though they have it. They don't believe in it, and they don't get the benefit of it. You got to believe in the blood of Jesus makes us whole. Amen? It's Jesus Christ's blood that was shed. There had to be a sacrifice. We're getting ready to read that. I want you to see it for yourself. Hebrews 9, 22. Are you there? Hebrews 9 and 22. And almost all things are by the law purged with what? And without what? The shedding of blood is no remission. If there's no bloodshed, then that thing does not. It's not going to be taken away. That's the only way that we'll fix it. We'll restore what it was that has been damaged, is the shedding of blood. And so the Lord is saying, without the shedding of Jesus' blood, none of us could have salvation today. But because of the blood of Jesus that was shed, we have now remission. Amen. The stain of sin has been removed from our lives. Amen. In the 23rd verse, it says, it was therefore necessary that the patterns of things in the heavens should be purified with these, but the heavenly things themselves with better sacrifices than these. For Christ is not entered into the holy places made with hands, which are the figures of the true, but in heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God for us. And so Jesus took his blood back to heaven, and that his blood was offered back to God as a sacrifice that would deliver all of us from whatever it was that we were held by the sin of Adam. Amen. Now look what it says, 25. It says, nor yet that he should offer himself often as the high priest entered into the holy place every year with the blood of others. He said, no, I don't have to do this like the high priest. Every year they got to go make a sacrifice. No, that's not what was needed. All Jesus had to do was offer his blood one time. Amen. And 26 says, for then must he often have suffered since the foundation of the world, but now once when? In the end of the world. Put a little pause right there. When did Jesus die? 2,000 years ago? Yes. And it said that when he did that, that was going to be the time of what? The end of the world. See, a lot of us don't understand that we're in time, but God's not in time. If you understand that when we think about time, it don't have a reference point with God, because God is in eternity. God is in forever. So when you think about time, God told us in Peter, he said, now listen, one day is like 1,000 years. And 1,000 years is like one day. So time is not important to God. It's only important to us. But that God let us know that when Jesus died on the cross, it was the end of the world. See, a lot of us think, oh, this thing gonna keep going. No, it's not. It's surely winding up. I'm going to keep on saying it from this pulpit. We don't have a lot of time left. If it was 2,000 years ago and that was the end of time or the end of the world, then we ought to realize that we are much closer than then. And some of us that are in our 50s and on up, we can testify that stuff we see right now going on, we didn't see 30 years ago. Can I get a witness? Now tell me the world ain't waxing worse and worse. Tell me people are not more and more and more being overtaken by demonic spirits. No fear of God, no reverence for God, just a constant living their lives as if there is no end coming. And that's why you and I better get some of Jesus' blood on us, because when he comes with the death angel for the whole world, he needs to see the blood on your life so that he'll pass over. Hallelujah. Y'all still with me? And as it is appointed unto men once to die. Anybody in here believe in coming back as a frog or a dog or an elephant? It ain't going to happen. You know, again, I like to say this, because whenever you're preaching from God's word, it's no effect if people don't believe that this is God's word. And that's one of the biggest tricks of Satan, to convince people that when ministers are preaching to them out of God's word, they have been told that it's really not God's word. So you don't have to be concerned. But if you believe that this is God's word, then the Lord says in his word, you and I only have one time to live. We don't have no three lives and five lives. Don't live your life like you coming back again. You're not coming back. You're not coming back reincarnated. You're not coming back, for another life in another body in another time. This is it, one time through. And so you need the blood of Jesus to cover you. Amen. We need the blood of Jesus to cover us. Amen. And it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this, the judgment. There's going to be a day of judgment. What is judgment? It is the day that they will have all of us to stand before God and give an account of the deeds done in our bodies. We need to get some blood on us. We need to be able to know that it's the blood of Jesus that keeps us from being fornicators. It's the blood of Jesus that keeps us from being liars. It's the blood of Jesus that keeps us from practicing a homosexual lesbian lifestyle. It's the blood of Jesus that helps us to forgive. I was listening to Elder George Rose back in the office before we prayed. He shared with me, he had seen something on the internet about a woman who had died and went to hell. And when she got to hell, she seen her grandma there. And she was like, oh, no, why? My grandma went to church all of her life. And she said that because her grandma wouldn't forgive, her grandma went to church all of her life, but her grandma was in hell because she would not forgive. I'm amazed at church folks. I'm amazed. I'm a pastor, and I'm amazed at church folks, because what is it that we don't understand, that the church is a spiritual hospital? The church is a spiritual hospital. If you ever go over to Prevena or Call Hospital, and when you got there and didn't expect to see sick folks, then you got a problem. Because you went to a physical hospital for sick people. So you wouldn't be angry because when you got there, somebody had a heart problem. You wouldn't be upset when you find out somebody got kidney failure and somebody got high blood pressure and somebody got diabetes, because you went to a hospital for sick folks. The physical sick folks. This place is a spiritual hospital. So you shouldn't be surprised when you see folks in here that's got issues. You shouldn't be all upset. Well, he smokes or she drinks, or they shacking or they cussing or they lying. They in the spiritual hospital. They here to get treatment. Hello? They need to get delivered. So they come to the church, which is a spiritual hospital. I'm going to tell the whole truth. You know, a lot of folks go to the hospital and they get mad at the doctor. They get mad at him. When the doctor diagnosed their case, they say, oh, forget that old doctor. I ain't thinking about him. I ain't taking what he said I got to do. So they go home and die. They go home and die. How many of you ever heard of people going to the doctor and get blood work and x-rays, and that's when they found out they were sick? They didn't even know. They felt good when they walked in the office, and then the doctor said, sit down. We found this. We found that. And people come in here on Sunday after Sunday, and the Holy Ghost will tell them there's some stuff that you got that you didn't know. Uh-oh. And what happens? Just like the physical people, they leave the doctor's office and forget Pastor Miller. I ain't thinking about him. And when you go to your doctor writes prescriptions. He said, now you take this right here, call me in the morning. And so I leave here always telling y'all, take John, take Ephesians, take Psalms, take Proverbs, take Revelation. And when they write you that prescription, you get mad and say, I ain't taking that. So you leave here and die. Mm-hmm. And this is the thing. How many know whenever you leave, your doctor always wants you to come back for a checkup? And a lot of us, this is what we do. I feel pretty good now. Forget him. I ain't going to pay him no more money. I feel all right. And so you don't even know that the sickness that the doctor diagnosed still needs some more medicine. They still need to write you another prescription for it. And everybody that come in here on Sunday morning, you here for a checkup. If you don't think you're here for a checkup, then why are you here? Oh, you here to chuck rocks. You here to talk about the other sick folks that are here. This is a whole room full of sick folks, starting with the pulpit. Everybody, I got some Bible. It is a fact that what's wrong with us is that we come into church for the wrong reasons. Now, anybody that go to the hospital for yourself, why would you go there and then talk about everybody else is sick? You in the hospital too. You laying in the bed too, talking about all these sick folks. I can't believe how many sick folks is up. You sick too. You got an IV hooked up to your arm. You got three prescriptions. They shooting stuff in your arm. And you got nerve to look over at the other guy in the other bed talking about with his old sick self. Won't we do it in church? Won't we do it in church? You got a lying problem, but they got another problem. You got a smoking problem, but they got another problem. You got a drug problem, but they got another problem. But you all in the same room with the sick folks. You sick too, but you got arrogance with your sickness. Their sickness is unto death. Mine is not. They need a heart transplant. All I need is my arteries cleaned out. We got church all messed up. We really got church messed up. That's why folks don't like to come to church, because the folks in the church, sickos, acting like the other folks coming in is the only one sick. Room full of sick folks mad when other sick folks, what's she doing here? Same thing you doing here. Trying to get some prescriptions on how to get that sickness out of their body, out of their mind, out of their heart, out of their soul. You ought to be able to relate, because you sick too. Who in here don't need the blood of Jesus to cover you? Who in this room don't need the grace of God on you? Living in a glass house, chucking rocks all the time. Caught the woman directly in adultery and said, if you that don't have no sin, chuck a rock. I got Bible. I ain't done. But I'll just pause for a minute. Don't you ever forget it. The church is for sick folks. Started with me and you. So every time you come in, just shake hands with sick folks like you. Hug sick folks like you. Y'all quiet now. No, no, no. If you can't say yes, then you now dealing with the sickness of a proud spirit. You may be dealing with arrogance. We studied in Bible study on Wednesday. God loves and God hates. Don't think God is just love. God hates division. God hates lying spirits. God hates false witnesses. God hates strife. God hates division. God hates those that cause discord among their brethren. God hates it. God hates it. Mm-hmm. I want to know how it is you going to the hospital mad because when you get there, other folks is sick. The only way you could be mad is you don't believe you sick. Y'all hear about it all the time. People drop dead. They didn't even know they were sick. out of nowhere, a heart attack. Boom. They didn't know the arteries was all clogged. They didn't even know it. They didn't feel like it. Some of the sickest things is that when you see folks on crack cocaine and they say they ain't sick. You ever been around folks that's really alcoholics, drug addicts, and you can't say nothing to them? They say, ain't nothing wrong with me. I preach to them every Sunday morning. Ain't nothing wrong with my heart. Meanest thing in the church. Ain't nothing wrong with me. All caught up in a life of sin, and you ain't talking to me, Pastor. Ain't nothing wrong with this shack. And what you mean? Ain't nothing wrong with fornicate. You going to hell. Fornicators are going to hell. Adulteresses are going to hell. Homosexuals are going to hell. Liars are going to hell. Backbiters are going to hell. Those that cause discord are going to hell. Chuck-a-rock, hide your hand, you're going to hell. Tired. Bunch of folks chunking rocks all the time. You ain't done nothing? Then shut up. Amen. Talking about the blood covers all of us. Everybody in here covered by the blood. He died. I got some Bible. Let me finish these little few verses. Where was I supposed to finish yet? I was at Hebrew 9. Did I get to 28 yet? Let's try 26. For then must he often, okay, let's do 27. And as it is appointed unto men once to die, but after that to judge. So Christ was once offended. Christ was once offered to bear the sins of many, and unto them that look for them, for him, shall he appear the second time without sin unto salvation. Amen? Everything that was needed for you and I to have victory was done through Jesus Christ. Everything that you need and I is in the blood of Jesus. Everything we need is covered in the blood of Jesus. Come on, look at Romans real quick. 3. I'm about done. Thank you for your word. Romans 3 and 25. Wasting your money. Going to the doctor and won't take the prescriptions. Going to church every Sunday, but you won't receive what the doctor tells you. Not Dr. Miller, Dr. Jesus. He the one writing the prescriptions. I'm just a servant boy who hand them to you. This is what Dr. Jesus said. Take these two right here and call him in the morning. Yeah. Don't call me, call him. Amen. Tell Jesus, it ain't working. Jesus, I'll write you some more. But I'll tell you the truth, it works. How many know you got to receive it, though? He's not guessing. He's not practicing medicine. Some doctors are categorized as practicing. They're trying to use it as a guinea pig. Y'all be careful when y'all go there when they always got free stuff to give you. Doctors say, oh, yeah, I got some free samples. Ooh, you got two heads. Come back. It's amazing, y'all, isn't it? When you read now the fine print of these medicines they give, they say you want to get rid of your headaches. Well, okay, take these, but the side effects is it might kill you. I guess you won't have a headache no more if it'll kill you. Yeah, it'll get rid of your headache, but you might have convulsions. Well, you might have convulsions. Yeah, take this right here. You won't have a headache anymore, but you won't be able to talk. This is the one that really blew me away. I don't know what medicine was, but it said, if you take this, you might want to kill yourself. What kind of? You know, I think I'll do okay just praying. Then, you know, because the stuff y'all giving it says you will now commit maybe suicide. I like this one, too. And you might, what you call, walk in your sleep. You know, you out in the middle of your neighborhood in your pajamas. Oh, Sister Melissa, hopefully you got your pajamas on because somebody might sleep in the nude tonight. And don't wake up till you get to jail, like. Amen. Come on, say you better believe. You better plead the blood. Come on, somebody. I believe the blood of Jesus heals me. Come on, physical and spiritual and mental. Amen. The blood of Jesus takes care of it. Hallelujah. Now look at this real quick. 3 of Romans 22. 3:22. Romans 3:22 says, even the righteousness of God, which is by faith of Jesus Christ unto all and upon all them that believe, for there is no difference. I like this 23. What does it say? Everybody read it. Hold it. Stop. Read it again. Stop. Read it again. Some of y'all won't read it. Read it all. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. That means everybody in here, we need some blood of Jesus on us. Everybody in here needs the blood of Jesus. And everybody in here ought to thank God that he shed his blood for all of us. Hallelujah. Don't let nobody tell you that his blood wasn't shed for you. Yes, it was. You don't have any hang-ups that Jesus' blood was not shed for. You don't have any generational curses that his blood did not cover. You do not have any physical sicknesses that his blood did not cover. Amen? He says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. 24 says, being justified freely by his what? His grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. Everybody enjoy the grace of God. The grace of God has been given to us not because we qualified. Grace is a blessing that you did not deserve nor could you earn. That's what grace is. It's a given to us, not because we are worthy. It's because God loves his children. Anybody ever gave your children something they didn't deserve? Anybody ever bless your children when they didn't really have nothing coming? That's what God does every day. He blesses us, and we are not good children. Y'all quiet. Y'all quiet now. That's why we don't do good in church, because we think we're the only ones saved. Everybody in here done messed up. And everybody in here still messing up. Oh, that part really didn't go. I said, everybody in here still messing up. What day do you don't need grace? I'm going to tell him to take it off of you. See how long you live. Every day that you and I live, we need the grace of God, unmerited favor. Don't let the enemy use you as if to say you don't need grace. You need grace. I need grace. Everybody needs grace. Amen. Come on, 25, it says, whom God has set forth to be a propitiation through faith in his blood. Huh? How did it happen? Through the blood. That's what it is, the power of his blood to declare his righteousness for the remission of sins that are passed through the forbearance of God. Amen? Come on, somebody said, the power of his blood, faith in his blood. Well, you and I got to have faith in that blood, amen? Okay, this is the last one. I want to finalize it. Just, you know, this is just a little sidebar right here in Acts 17 and 26. Because we got problems with earth suits. Your body is an earth suit. And we got problems with people who have different skin colors. Yeah, they got a different suit on, and so you got an issue with them. Brown suits, black suits, white suits, red suits, but you fighting suits. Yeah. You know, you really not that intelligent if you stand out there and say, I'm mad because that's a red truck. Because I don't like red. But there's a human driving that red truck. They not a truck because they drive one. And there's a white car, a beige car. I don't like that color. But there's a human inside of it. Why would you beat up on that car because you don't like the color? Because there's a person inside you're going to damage. I said you're going to damage the person on the inside if you don't like the earth suit that they in. You're going to damage the person, the real person. The person is not the car. The person lives on the inside that's driving the car. You and I are spirit beings, and we live in earth suits. Tell me our world ain't messed up and we killing each other all over this world because of religion and because of skin color and because of backgrounds. Humans killing all humans. I said humans are the ones that are killing other humans. Assault weapons. We create guns to kill one another. They created by humans to kill other humans. They're not trying to kill Bambi. They're trying to kill other humans. Yogi the Bear ain't got nothing to worry about. They ain't looking for him. Boo-boo, none of them. They're just looking for us. Amen. Every now and then, Yogi might get your lunch box, but it's kind of funny, too. I'm going to move on. People out in the woods wondering why bears jumping on them. You went to a bear's house and he said, why the bear cut me? Because you're in this house. Hey, man, the people building their houses way out there in the woods and they come outdoors and the bear's in their pool. What is Yogi and Boo Boo doing out in my pool? They thought it was the lake. Amen. This is it, 17 and 26. And has made of one blood how many nations? All nations of men for to dwell on all the face of the earth. One blood. And no dog blood and human blood. It's dog blood and it's human blood. Cat blood and human blood. There's no human blood and then some other kind of alien human blood. It's all human blood. I like to be a medical doctor that's getting ready to perform surgery, and I find out that whatever your skin color is, you don't like other folks' skin. And so I'll come right into your operating room, and I say, just a minute, Bubba. I got Billy Bob blood. You want it? They don't never turn down when they're in the hospital. They don't never ask the people with the blood on the little stick up there, who blood is that? They don't even question it. They just get to it. Don't ask nothing about the kidney. Where'd it come from? They said, give it to me. Y'all quiet now. We got all this attitude, but God said, it's one blood for all nations. Ain't no white blood and black blood and Hispanic blood and Asian blood and African blood. It's one blood for all ethnicities. Come on, rest on your feet. It's the power of Jesus' blood that covers the whole nation, covers the whole world. Amen? Jesus' blood was shed on Calvary for everyone. Some folks don't believe, hey, I don't want this person. I don't like this person. Get sick and see what you do. Mm-hmm. Margot's blood will be just fine. Shaniqua's blood. Anyway, let me quit because I'm probably messing up right now. That's why I use Margot. That's the one that I usually can get by without nobody talking to me after church. Bubba usually go over pretty good for me. I'm just trying to make a point. How many of you know all of us got the blood of Jesus that covers us? Every one of us in this room is the blood of Jesus. That's what gives us the grace of God. Come on, Sister Miller, please. Thank you, Jesus. It's the blood of Jesus that covers all of us, no matter who we are, what our background, our skin color. Jesus died. Whoever you are, I'm praying that this message will reach China and Japan and India and every part of the world, because there's no other blood. There's no other blood. I hope it reaches an atheist. I hope it reaches an agnostic. I hope it reaches a homosexual, a lesbian. I hope it reaches some church folks who believe they're the only church that's going to heaven. No, it's the blood of Jesus that covers everyone. Everybody. Nobody is going to heaven that don't have the blood of Jesus covering you. So I'm praying that you will accept him. If you haven't, pray right now. Jesus, come into my life. I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. You pray that little simple prayer, you are saved. And begin to believe and apply the blood of Jesus over your life. begin to claim it, that when you're in trouble, the blood of Jesus covers you. We're New Life Church of Faith. We're in Danville and Champaign. We're in Champaign at the Lincoln Square Mall. That's 201 Lincoln Square, and that's an 8 o'clock service. We're in Danville at the Heavenly Square Mall, and that's 1419 Bowman Avenue. That's 11 o'clock service on Sunday mornings. God bless you. All right, please don't leave. It's about 10 till, 12 till.